Hi, I'm Sandy Alnock, and I'm president of Operation Right Home, and I'm here to bring you the State of the Operation message. First, a thank you to our heroes watching this. You're all the reason that OWH even exists. You're the reason our nation stands strong and free, and we are so grateful. Your courage, dedication, and willingness to sacrifice yourselves on our behalf are an inspiration and a blessing. Keep safe out there, do your job well, write to your mom, and know that we stand behind you 100%. To our card makers, you make all of this possible with your amazing creativity. Our shippers are inspired by you. Our heroes regularly write to tell us how impressed they are by your handiwork. Thank you for giving of your time, your talents, and the treasures of supplies that you use to make the cards. To our financial donors, how do we even begin to thank you for being the engine that keeps us going? Your gifts, both large and small, make a difference in keeping the post office well-fed, keeping our website up and running, purchasing envelopes, and taking care of those behind-the-scenes tasks that are so necessary. And to all the companies who have donated supplies for our card challenge prizes, bless you for your generosity. And giant thanks go out to our shippers who have put in countless hours of sorting, shipping, packing, emailing, and giving so much of their lives to this project. It wouldn't be possible without them. And I'm so very grateful for each and every one of them who has served throughout the year and since the beginning of the organization's conception. 2009 saw so many changes for us. Increases in card volume, the excitement of blog hops, new partnerships, hundreds and hundreds of card makers newly addicted to serving our heroes. But the largest change was probably the name and the website. After a long series of events, we changed from Cards for Heroes to Operation Right Home in September, and what a blessing that's been. Thank you to all of those who helped us through that transition, especially our attorneys and our board of directors who slogged through IRS forms and Skype meetings to nail down the details. It's amazing now that many people can't even remember what the old name was only a few months later. The number of cards received and then mailed out to our heroes has been astonishing in 2009. Almost 240,000, and 100,000 of those were in the Christmas season alone. It's no wonder our shippers were just a bit tired throughout the fall. But that brings me to another thing to celebrate, and that's the number of people who have been stamping the backs of their cards, learning the tuck, including packing slips in their boxes. And by doing these things, helping to make our shippers' jobs easier. The extra few minutes that you take on your end makes a world of difference on ours, so thank you. We also saw a huge increase in Operation Right Home's social media presence in 2009. First among bloggers, as our blog hops took off with over 200 blogs participating throughout the year, and then on Facebook and Twitter. Our Facebook fan page has been an incredible resource for all of us to get inspired, learn tips and tricks, see pictures of each other's cards, laugh together, and become more of an OWH family as we get to know each other. Our new Stars and Stamps blog began just this month, stemming out of all the crafters who wanted to really develop our community and encourage each other. That's what social media is all about, friends. And so the more that all of these blogs and Facebook fans comment, post, link, and generally chatter about us, the higher our rankings are going to be on Google and Facebook, the more free advertising we get from them, which all leads to inviting even more crafters to join us on our mission. It's a win-win all around. As we get further into 2010 and find more of our service members leaving Iraq, our focus on Afghanistan might become more prominent. We'll be working on making more connections with those deploying there, and we may find ourselves moving some of our deadlines earlier to accommodate longer shipping time for the boxes. So stay tuned to the Homefront blog as that begins to develop. The heavy deployments to Afghanistan may also mean we need more cards. Many locations there don't have regular internet access, unlike Iraq, where it was much more common. So therefore, writing letters home could be an even more urgent need for those who are deployed there. This year, we're also working on more back-end database details to smooth out our processes, complete with automated receipts. You have no idea what a blessing that will be. And we're also going to be moving further on the process to register our trademark for our name, Operation Write Home, and fundraising for the fees that that process will incur. I'd like to close with a letter that just came in yesterday. And it arrived on this card. And it says, I was thrilled to find a box of cards from my favorite, underscored five times and capitalized, favorite support group in the pile of my packages. I can't even begin to tell you how much joy and envy your cards have brought to my family and friends. Our deployment is ending soon. I will certainly miss the men and women I have served with here, but I will also miss the gorgeous box of cards and think of your group every time I buy a card in the future. Thank you for all your efforts and kindness. Much love, Lieutenant Commander in Iraq. So God bless our heroes, God bless our OWH family, and God bless America.